Everybody talks about government, but do we really know what we're talking about? My name is Rodrigo Guim, anthropologist and social critic, and this is Critique with Nietzsche and Foucault. In the book based on the lecture of the same name, Security, Territory, and Population, Michel Foucault demonstrates that biopolitics is part of a certain governmentality that in our present still exists in the form of neoliberal governmentality. The book reads, "By this word governmentality, I mean three things. First, by governmentality, I understand the ensemble formed by institutions, procedures, analyses and reflections, calculations and tactics that allow the exercise of this very specific, albeit very complex, power that has the population as its target, political economy as its major form of knowledge, and apparatuses of security as its essential technical instrument. Second, by governmentality, I understand the tendency, the line of force, that for a long time and throughout the West has constantly led towards the preeminence over all other types of power, sovereignty, discipline, and so on, of the type of power that we can call government, and which has led to the development of a series of specific governmental apparatuses, on the one hand, and on the other, to the development of a series of knowledges. Finally, by governmentality, I think we should understand the process, or rather, the result of the process by which the state of justice of the Middle Ages became the administrative state in the 15th and 16th centuries and was gradually governmentalized." End of citation. Foucault here emphasizes the objectives of his study, explaining what he meant when he explained this study as a history of governmentality. For the sake of the history he was speaking of, which is also a history of the present in Foucault's genealogical work, I will quote him extensively before giving my own understanding of what he said in the end of the video. I don't claim to be an expert on Foucault, since this is precisely one of the processes Foucault critiques, of knowledge based on first principles, foundations. Knowledge is nothing more than arbitrary, although inextricably linked to power relations, to social practices, to the construction of discourses on truth, and based on the various subject positions of class, race, gender, nation, language, culture, history, etc., that are present in any justification for knowledge. Knowledges, for Foucault, are avenues for the naturalization of time and space, or of the discourses that surround them. Knowledge, as based on metaphysics as cultural practice, on Christian secular culture, on political economy as its language that is premised on the concepts of neutrality, and on the state, the arbiter of apparatuses of security that works in the name of a supposed universal rationality. Knowledge in this legacy acts dominantly in the service of such that are the forms of dominant Western culture. Foucault's relation to Western thought is so intimate that he cannot be categorized within the binaries of Western thought of the true and false, right and wrong easily. Knowledge for him is unstable, and even when dominant, it needs to be continually reaffirming itself to hold on to its dominance. Knowledge is produced within specific social, cultural, and historical trends, and it's intimately tied to identity politics. Governmentality is then produced through a history of a process called governmentalization. It's a process. What we know today as government is an ensemble of forces linked to forms of knowledge, of which the dominant form is political economy, and an object-subject double called the population, which is the target of government, seen at one time as origin of government itself and as its product as well, because population is something to be maximized, freed from its bad aspects. And the techniques of rationalization or apparatuses of security that inform rationalization of everyday life, like bureaucratization, management, and other administrative processes of rational control that equate rationality and freedom, and thus produce a specific type of controlled freedom. Governmentality is the possibility of the naturalization of this process of rational economic management of civil society by the state. The state itself is rationalized to only act in the pursuit of freedom, understood as the continuity of this rational management. The state appears then in a double bind. On the one hand, it needs to fully provide this rationalization so subjects can understand themselves to be acting freely and based on their self-interest. On the other hand, the state needs to do this in a way that invisibilizes itself as an acting power. This operates in a way that produces a discourse on the state as the center of power. Says Michel Foucault, citation, "We know the fascination that the love or horror of the state exercises today. We know our attachment to the birth of the state, to its history, advance, power, and abuses. I think this overvaluation of the problem of the state is basically found in two forms. An immediate, affective, and tragic form is the lyricism of the cold monster confronting us. But there is a second way of overvaluing the problem of the state that is paradoxical because apparently reductive. This analysis consists in reducing the state to a number of functions like, for example, the development of the productive forces and the reproduction of the relations of production. But the state, doubtless no more today than in the past, does not have this unity, individuality, and rigorous functionality, nor, I would go so far as to say, this importance. After all, maybe the state is only a composite reality and a mythicized abstraction whose importance is much less than we think. Maybe. What is important for our modernity, that is to say for our present, is not then the state's takeover of society so much as what I would call the governmentalization of the state." End of citation. The modern state is partially the result of a historical process called governmentality. However, in no way does Foucault reduce the state to governmentality as its only place of production. Governmentality is what has permitted the modern nation-state to rise and take shape, to construct a discourse for itself as both natural and in continuous development or progress. Depending on which state we're looking at, some will be always in development, like the third world countries, and others, like first world countries, will be discoursed as in progress. The discourse of the state's takeover of society is precisely the discourse of neoliberal governmentality, which posits the state as an actor that needs to act only when individual actions of groups or individuals of civil society fail to act in relation to each other in ways that guarantee that the game of economics and politics are played with fairness. The state is that agent that civil society would like to do without, but cannot when individual self-interests collide or go against each other. Then, and only then, is the state seen as a rational actor and legitimized in its interventions. says Foucault, citation, "We live in the era of a governmentality discovered in the 18th century. Governmentalization of the state is a particularly contorted phenomenon, since if the problems of governmentality and the techniques of government have really become the only political stake and the only real space of political struggle and contestation, the governmentalization of the state has nonetheless been what has allowed the state to survive. And it is likely that if the state is what it is today, it is precisely thanks to this governmentality that is at the same time both external and internal to the state, since it is the tactics of government that allow the continual definition of what should or should not fall within the state's domain, what is public and what is private, what is and is not within the state's competence, and so on. So, if you like, the survival and limits of the state should be understood on the basis of the general tactics of governmentality." End of citation. For anything to maintain itself dominant in society, politics, economics, religion, history, language, and culture, a constant reaffirmation of borders becomes necessary to keep the contours of the political landscape moving in ways that obfuscate from vision and from thought historical dynamics, and with them, dynamics of knowledge and power. Foucault linked discourse to power relations in ways that show how forms of knowledge legitimate and reproduce power relations and subject positions aligned with those. In today's neoliberal governmentality, the production of the homo economicus was an effect of certain power relations. There is here no subject prior to history. Subjectivity has a history, and this history is intimately tied to the configurations of power through institutions, language, and cultural practices, says Foucault, citation. And maybe in a completely general, rough, and therefore inexact way, we could reconstruct the major forms, the major economies of power, in the following way. First, the state of justice, born in a feudal type of territoriality and broadly corresponding to a society of customary and written law, with a whole interplay of commitments and litigations. Second, the administrative state that corresponds to a society of regulations and disciplines. And finally, a state of government that is no longer essentially defined by its territoriality, by the surface occupied, but by a mass, the mass of the population, with its volume, its density, and for sure the territory it covers, but which is, in a way, only one of its components. This state of government, which essentially bears on the population and calls upon and employs economic knowledge as an instrument, would correspond to a society controlled by apparatuses of security. End of citation. Thus, Foucault shows how government came to be on top of other forms of power that are different from it, although government also came as an extension of the role of territoriality and of administrative apparatuses that were then linked to the population comprised within its borders and over which it came to see itself as promoter of security and freedom, both seen as operating at the same level of rationality. To practice security, the state needed to found its action on the population, who is to be maximized, that is, be managed in a way that produces maximum health, happiness, normality, and productivity to this same population. Within this system, the state is to cooperate in the maximization of the population, together with authorities on truth, as presented in knowledge, markets, and technology. In no way is the state central in relation to power relations. Power operates from many relations, one of which is the process of subjectivation linked to pastoral power. Let's now move to the end of the lecture of February 1st, 1978, at the middle of which I started the citations I made before. To end the lecture of the day, Foucault then says that he will next show, citation, how this governmentality was born, first, from the archaic model of the Christian pastorate, and second, by drawing support from a diplomatic military model, or rather technique, and finally, third, how it could only acquire its present dimensions thanks to a set of very specific instruments, the formation of which is exactly contemporaneous with the art of government, and which is called, in the old 17th and 18th century sense of the word, police. I think the pastoral, the new diplomatic military technique, and finally police were the three major points of support on the basis of which that fundamental phenomenon in the history of the West, the governmentalization of the state, could be produced. End of citation. Pastoral power represents one of the main forces of the history of the production of governmentality. It has linked, like never before, the practices of self, as Foucault says, to a condition of knowledge being primary to action, and this knowledge as linked to a higher authority on truth. The subject is produced in such a way that relations of self to self operate as the highest priority and value. This means the denigration and regression of the political realm, where relations to difference, to others, to the future as open, to the incommensurability of reality, are also lost. In neoliberal governmentality, processes of individualization are central, that is, the production of subjectivity through citation. Procedures of individualization that will, in fact, be implemented by the Christian pastorate and its institutions. What the history of the pastorate involves, therefore, is the entire history of procedures of human individualization in the West. Let's say also that it involves the history of the subject. End of citation. What pastoral power produced as a process of governmentality and in relation to this procedure called individualization is a mode of subjectivity where the relation of self to self, mediated by an authority on truth, impedes the politicization of knowledge through which relational knowledge, as Foucault says, would be prioritized. In this system of thought, liberation comes through confession of truth of the self to an authority on truth, a guru, a priest, and submission to this authority is considered freedom. In the present neoliberal form of governmentality, the self looks to maximize itself in a self-interest obedience to an authority. Obedience to authority rests on the identity of the truth held by that authority and the truth of the self. This form of subjugation and subjectivation is what is then called freedom. In it, links to communities, to struggles, to the political are erased in the name of the subject's maximizing of itself as a political economic resource. Apparatuses of security come in here to make sure that the subject will be able to affirm itself in a rationalized market where its needs and desires can all be met if the subject is linked to markets, technology, and knowledge that will affirm the truth of the self. Understanding governmentality is to understand how the dominant forms of subjectivity in the West, produced in the legacy of Christian narratives of salvation of the soul and of the doubleness of heart and soul, are part of the political problem. It's not that by founding a new subjectivity by itself that then resistance is guaranteed. Subjectivation happens within institutional, discursive, and cultural historic practices that are linked to each other, such that if institutions and practices don't change, the change of subjectivity means little to nothing in the political order, since it is this order that subjectivizes. Resistance to the organization of practices of self is certainly necessary. However, political resistance would realize the need for alliances between social movements and subjects to make possible social change that is not subject or truth-centered or identity-centered. Liberal political culture produces the obedience to self as the avenue to escape oppression. It doesn't think the process of subjectivation or of self as a political practice. What governance in liberalism does is to protect the sanctity of private subjects. In this order, the only job of the political sphere is to safeguard individual private liberties and interests. The state only acts when private interests are threatened, and this is seen as political action, when in fact it is the maintenance of individualization as the only desirable action. In its forms of knowledge, the knowledges that it legitimates, which speak the language of political economy, this order is based on the dualisms of individual versus society or state versus civil society. Society is the constant threat to the individual here, and the state is the constant threat to civil society. This state, equated with the political, or the political reduced to the rationalized action of the state, is politics that must act in a way that invisibilizes its action in neoliberal governmentality. It must only do that which civil society cannot manage to do alone. It must let nature or civil society act, but it must also, in the same action, even correct nature or civil society when its actions disrespect the interest of rationality, mobility, circulation, and distribution of resources. These actions, discoursed as the political itself, happen through apparatuses of security. Apparatuses of security are mechanisms that support, according to the high value put on rational self-interest, that is to be the basis of political action, or rather the limit to political action. It supports the maximization of people and things as resources. Liberalism thus fetishizes the technological as its example of the highest rationality. It instrumentalizes rationality and then uses its own instrumentalization to justify rationality as its foundation. Security is applied on the population as an object-subject double, as both the object to be known and through this knowledge managed and controlled, as well as the subject on whom knowledge is grounded. That is, knowledge is possible because the population is always seeking to maximize itself, or rather, it is the motor of history where progress and evolution could be verified. In this narrative, every violence is justified as part of a continuous process of progress and development, depending on the country we're speaking of. Those that fail or resist individualization are seen as lacking, and this biopolitical order will make sure that they are either incorporated or annihilated from the order. Where is the political to be found today that is not action within biopolitics and neoliberal governmentality? Social movements and subjects today reproduce biopolitics and neoliberalism when they insist on a truth of themselves that is an identity that holds their unity. Identity politics is one of the spaces where this reproduction occurs. However, there are movements and subjects that not only reproduce but also challenge the biopolitical order. For example, the queer movement chose for itself the name queer as a way to resist the confining identities that are based on a sexuality as a truth of the subject. However, there is tremendous variety within this movement itself, and in it we find as well the old identity politics that ascribes truth to subjects with sex as an interior truth of subjectivity. Besides this example, we can say that all social movements today, because they are living within forms of neoliberalism, reproduce biopolitics in one form or another. To resist neoliberal governmentality, because it reduces possibilities for political action, means to promote knowledges, forms of subjectivation, and political alliances that are not based on truth or identity. It means cultivating alliances across differences, making possible political action based on striving for justice that is non-foundational. Well, people, thank you all. I want to thank all my supporters that have taken courses with me on Patreon and other websites. Thank you for all your support, and see you soon.